On November 27th of 2022, the first eruption of the Mauna Loa volcano in Hawaii in 38 years began. It is now day 2 of the eruption, and the nature of the eruption has changed. After the first several hours of eruptive activity, which consisted of fissures erupting fountains of lava confined to Mauna Loa's summit caldera, the intensity of heat signatures at the summit soon decreased. Lava was instead moving through the volcano's northeast rift zone and would soon after emerge several miles to the northeast. As of 7:15 a.m. local time, three new fissures were geolocated between 2.6 and 4 miles northeast of the center of Mauna Loa's caldera. These fissures each produced numerous smaller lava fountains along a chain of activity, quickly emitting large volumes of lava at a rate which I personally estimate was at a very minimum 70 cubic meters per second. Supporting an assumption of a high rate of lava effusion is the fact that the advancing lava flows have a jagged surface being known as A'a. A'a lava flows imply a higher rate of lava effusion than Pohoihoi lava flows, which in contrast have a ropey appearance. Although lava traveling 3 miles in the direction of the city of Hilo might be worrying, it is still a long distance away from the city. Given current data, lava flows are 13 miles away from the first structure which might be encountered and 26 miles away from the outskirts of Hilo. Since the slopes of Mauna Loa are very gentle in this direction, lava flows generally take on the order of weeks to months to reach populated areas. Lava flows generally advance the fastest during the first several days but will soon after slow down significantly or completely stall. For example, using historical lava flows, it took 22 days for lava to advance within 10 miles of Hilo in 1984, and it took 280 days for lava to advance within 2 miles of Hilo in 1881. Today, several neighborhoods are built on top of the 1881 lava flow, indicating the general risk that these structures could face in an unusually long eruption. Speaking of eruption durations, Mauna Loa has historically produced eruptions which have lasted between 22 hours and 280 days, with the extremes having occurred in 1975 and 1880 to 1881 respectively. There really is not a method to determine how long an eruption will last. Just because it has been an unusually long time since Mauna Loa's last eruption in 1984 does not mean that the ongoing eruption will be larger or longer than normal. Whether this eruption abruptly ends the day this video is published or 6 months from now is unclear, and only time will tell. During the initial stage of the eruption, I estimated the lava fountain height even from a distance to be maxing out at around 200 feet, at least at the time that footage shown on screen was recorded, courtesy of the TwoPineapples YouTube channel. Estimating the height of a lava fountain is relatively easy to do. All that is needed is to time how long it takes for a fragment of lava at its peak height the moment before it starts descending to impact the ground. Using a formula of 4.905 multiplied by the number of seconds squared, you get a height in meters. Although this ignores air resistance, in this case it took 2.4 seconds, meaning the lava fountain had a height of approximately 28.3 meters or 92.7 feet. As the days progress, the U.S. Geological Survey and associated agencies will release more information on the exact outline of where lava has erupted, the composition of the lava, and the rate of lava effusion. These details will allow volcanologists to better analyze the ongoing eruption, in part due to establishing a baseline. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank my new turquoise tier YouTube member, Judy Menzel, for supporting this channel.